Offiziere in Söhnen und 1984. Ladies and gentlemen, in the name of the Press Committee, I have the honor and the pleasure cordially to welcome all those who by their presence on today's ceremony manifest their sympathy and their sincere gratitude to our American liberators, and especially to the veterans of the past Infantry Division. May those two stories, the one of Normandy, the other of the Ardennes, with the third of America, remember to passers-by the sacrifices of the American soldiers in 1944 for our liberation from Nazi domination, and today for the protection of our freedom and our humanist civilization. Glory and thankfulness to those of 1944, glory to their sons of 1984. Toutes les affaires et les troisièmes d'Amérique, l'affaire de passeport sur le fait, vas-y, prenez le monument. Und nun, wie man das hört, in Gedenkstein enthüllen.
En commémoration du sacrifice de tant de jeunes et comme un signe qui invite le passant à un engagement personnel pour la liberté et la paix. Gott, du Ursprung aller Gemeinschaft, Gott der Versöhnung des Friedens, segne dieses Denkmal, das uns an das Opfer vieler junger Menschen erinnert und bestärke in uns allen den Willen zur gegenseitigen Achtung. In Gerechtigkeit und Freiheit durch Christus, unseren Herrn. Amen.
I leave the words now to Mr. Norrelly, commander of the American Legion, Captain B. La parole est à M. Norrelly. Commandant de la Légion pour le nord de la Belgique. Es spricht Herr Noëlli, Commandant der Allergen Légion de Nord-Belgien.
Monsieur le ministre belge, général, monsieur le député de France, distinguished guests, soldiers, veterans, ladies and gentlemen, I thank you for coming. In the name of Flanders Field Post number 2, in my function in the American Legion Belgium, I now dedicate this memorial. I dedicate it to the memory of those of the 1st Division who fell in the service of our country. I dedicate it in the name of those who offered their lives and justice, freedom and democracy may survive to be the victorious ideals of the peoples of the world. The lives of those who have made the supreme sacrifice are glorious before us. their deeds are inspiration. As thy servant America, in time of war, you do the last mission of devotion. May we serve America in time of peace. I dedicate this monument to them, and with it, I dedicate the American Legion and the street box number 2 to the faithful service of our country and to preservation of the memory of those who have died at the liberty of life. Let us pray. Whose bodies constitute our country tomorrow, but also those who sleep beyond the seas and those others whose resting places will not be known until the last day when the debris of even of these dead. O God, teach us to honor them by ever cherishing ideas for respecting. Give us the steadfast and firm in righteousness, honor of heart and unselfish service.
Mr. Gentius, to present you the mayor of the city, will say a few words.
Ladies and gentlemen, your being here on this solemn occasion of the inauguration of this stone commemorating the American Liberator of the 1st Division is a very great honor for us. A long fostered wish of the Eupen section of the American Legion is fulfilled today with the setting up of the commemorating stone. By their initiative, the Eupen section has recalled that we owe the fact to live in a free world today to the Allied forces and the American forces. The presence of numerous American veterans gives us the opportunity to express our deepest thanks to them, representing all those who helped to liberate Western Europe. For the freedom in which we live today, many have lost their lives. May this commemorating stone not only be a sign of our gratitude, but also an admonition for the youth. Möge dieser Gedenkstein nicht nur ein Zeichen der Dankbarkeit und der Verbundenheit sein, sondern eine Warnung. Nicht überall auf der Welt ist ein Leben in Freiheit, wie wir es hier führen, eine Selbstverständlichkeit. Deshalb ist Freiheit ein kostbares Gut, das beschützt werden muss und um dessen Erhalt man sich immer neu bemühen muss. Nirgends ist es so wichtig, billige Phrasen zu vermeiden wie bei diesem Thema. Nirgends ist es so wichtig, eine Sprache zu sprechen, die von allen verstanden wird. Gesetz Pierre, du Mitglied der 1. Division im Kriegszeichen.
My dear friends, today meetings make us realize all times fly by. We are all really 40 years older, physically perhaps, but not in our hearts. And in any case, today we all feel 40 years younger. I do remember, as it was yesterday, when I joined in Namur, the 1st Infantry Division, as liaison officer. I still remember that it was the 13th of September 1944, after 4 long years of occupation, that I crossed with the 1st the German border at New Moresnet. I recall very well the episode of the very sad Thanksgiving in the Eupen forest, the very difficult Christmas in Elsenborg, Wittenberg, Eupen. All of us, I'm sure, have such souvenirs that they keep warmly in their hearts. I am proud today to say to our American friends that the Belgians in general, and more specifically all those who lived in war years, remains deeply grateful for what the United States did. We owe you our freedom. You inspire us in our recovery, and you remain for us an inspiration in everyday life. Merci beaucoup. Thank you. And thank you.
Herr Child, Vorsitzender der Vereinigung der Veteranen der 1. Amerikanischen Division.
We come here today wholehearted to many memories. Memories of friends no longer with us. Memories of friends who died, of the hardships we suffered, and of the camaraderie that we created. First New Year, the oldest division of the United States Army, and as such, is very conscious of its history.
La première division de l'infanterie est la plus vieille division dans l'armée des États-Unis. À cause de ça, elle est très consciencieuse de sa réputation aux États-Unis.
More than any other division, it maintains contact between its veterans and those who serve in the division today.
Plus que d'autres divisions, elle maintient un contact avec ses vétérans et avec ses soldats en service aujourd'hui.
The honor of the city of appointment pays to our veterans in 1944 fills the soldiers of today with pride.
L'honneur de la ville de France
expresses our hope and the bonds, one of the bonds, which binds our two nations and their continued alliance with the French people.
Ça nous garde nos deux pays dans une alliance continuelle en espérant que nous resterons en paix.
Merci. Thank you very much.
Thank you.